Hey everyone! Today we're going to talk about our friends, Queen. So let's get started. So, in November of 1991, our main singer and songwriter, Freddie Mercury, passed away. The news of his passing shocked fans throughout the world. And as a tribute to Freddie, the songs Bohemian Rhapsody and These Are the Days of Our Lives was released as a double A-sided single to raise funds for a charity that was set up following his passing. The double A-sided single entered the UK chart at number one, where it stayed for 5 weeks, raising over $1.4 million for the charity. Queen became the first band to have the same single top the UK charts twice. Brian and Roger continued to be managers of the charity after that. And today, the charity has helped over 800 projects worldwide and raised over $16 million in total. In December of 1991, Queen had 10 albums in the UK Top 100. In 1992, the Outstanding Contribution to British Music Award was given to Freddie Mercury, even though he was not alive to receive it. And in 1995, the tracks that Queen had started in 1991 were completed by Brian, Roger, and John, and the long-awaited song, Made in Heaven, was released worldwide. And it was considered the end of an era, which basically just means it was the end of the main time that everybody knew of as Queen, because they lost their main singer. Since then, Queen's music and legacy has remained, with continuing sales for their records on CD, video, and now digitally online. Queen's first DVD, Greatest Video Hits Volume 1, was released in 2002, and yet another part of Queen made it to the UK charts at number 1. That same year, Queen received their own star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame in Los Angeles, California, joining the Beatles as only one of a handful of non-US bands to receive one. In 2004, they were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and the UK inducted them into the first UK Music Hall of Fame. And there is a Queen's musical that is performed in Las Vegas, Nevada, Australia, Spain, Russia, Germany, and Japan, and continues to have touring productions all across the world. So today we're going to listen to the song, We Are the Champions. And this song was written by lead singer and pianist, and main singer, right? We know that singer, songwriter, and pianist, Freddie Mercury, and released their 1977 album of News of the World. So we're going back in time a little bit. This song was an instant hit at number 2 on the UK charts, and number 4 in the US Billboard Hot 100, number 3 in Canada, and top 10 in many other countries as well. This song became the anthem for sporting events and the official theme song for the 1994 FIFA World Cup, which is the Soccer World Cup. In 2009, this song was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame and has been covered by many artists. So if you already know their music, enjoy. If you haven't heard this song before, I hope you like the song. So here we go. Let's take a listen.
Sentence, but committed no crime, and bad mistakes I've made a few. I've been myself sad, it's in my past, but I don't come through. We are champions for failure. We'll be right back.
taken my vows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all. But it's been a bed of roses. No pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge to follow you my way.
Okay. Doesn't it look like so much fun going to a Queen concert? Anywho, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed that song if you've never heard it before. And if you have heard it before, I hope you were singing along and enjoying it. Thank you for participating and listening along with me. And I will see you next time.